So let's analyze the games that we play in the tournament. This is the winner of the tournament, Skeroplos. This is one of my nightmares, this endgame, guys. I want you to show this endgame and to start to analyze with Stockfish this position. This is the position we must analyze, and let's show to people how to win h-pawn and rook versus bishop. This is the beginning of the tournament, so let's see this game. So it was a terrible time problem, rook g7 was correct. So let's analyze this position from this moment. From this moment, let's analyze the position. So the first mistake is bishop f3 in the game. This was the first mistake. Of course, in the game, bishop d3 was the good move to avoid the king from entering the diagonal. Of course, yes, it's winning in the sorium, but if the pawn is on h5 and the bishop is on d3, you will see that this is draw. I have seen many grandmasters make drawing this position. This is a nightmare for a grandmaster. If a grandmaster don't know this endgame, it's theoretical draw. Listen how the game went for the beginning and you will realize what I mean. In terrible time, white made this mistake, pushed the pawn on h5, and you see immediately evaluation of computer is draw. This position is draw. Of course, white tried to do his best, but now it's very difficult to win this position. And as you can see, they played a lot of moves, and the defense for black is easy, and Rodolfo's made the draw in this position. Maybe before it was winning, okay, but king f6, king g8, rook d7, and if black does not make any big mistake, the position is draw. Yes. Now this position is theoretical draw. Ah, now it says that here it was winning. Ah, yes, but black had played king h5, okay. Black had played king h5 and it was winning. Okay, many mistakes have been played in this game. So let's see how to win this position. In the end, okay, after a terrible time pressure, the game happened draw. So theoretically speaking, this endgame, guys, if the pawn reaches to h5, this is draw. The position is draw, so let's check the endgame. I will show you the endgame, how to win. If you are over 2000 player, learn it for me. So, okay, I will go to the important thing. Of course, let's see some mistakes in the beginning of the moment. This is the moment we must see this endgame. So, listen, which is the rule in general? In general, as a rule in this kind of position, let's see if I can put... Can I put computer more lines? Okay, let's put... Okay, in general, which is the rule in this line? So, the big trick for white is when you play, for example, the move rook g3, bishop c2, the major point in this endgame for white is to put the rook on g5 and slowly try to push the king on f4. If you have the time to bring the king out of the h pawn, this is winning. I go to the triple dots, yes. Yes, and I put here minimum line 3. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. This. Okay, thank you very much. Yes, I did it. Thank you very much, guys. So listen, what is happening in this endgame? So the major plan in this endgame, and what Skeroplos didn't know, is that you must find a way to bring the king on f4. Why the king on f4, first of all, is winning? Let's see why it's winning the endgame. So, that's why I say the move king h5. King h5 is the move for sure. Why I propose the move king h5. If black has the possibility to play bishop d1 check, for example, and white plays king g6. For example, if you do this mistake, king f6, the position is easy winning because only with the rook you can push the pawn and the pawn is promoted to queen. So this is impossible to happen. It's not so possible. So here the move is king f7. This is the theoretical proposition how to make a draw. And now the move for white is the move rook g5. This is a theoretical move in which black has two possibilities, or to play bishop here or to play king f6. If the game goes king f6, after king g4, this is the theoretical way to win this position. Yes. Yes, this is exactly... Yes, yes. NGR, Nick, exactly this exists in the book of Yusupo, but you know, my own experience, when I was playing the Acropolis tournament back to 2008, they asked me about this endgame, and really I didn't know it to tell you precise the technique how to win. I just know some lines, and I really want you to show you this, because a grandmaster made a draw here, and I know many players make a draw. So if your king can success, if you can succeed to put away your king, the position is completely winning. White's completely winning, because in this kind of position, the h pawn is unstoppable. Why it's unstoppable? Because white threat this this plan, which is unstoppable. So remember, bishop g6, rook g3. Now the position is zugzwang. No, no, it's very easy. No, no, no. And yeah, listen to me and you will realize. So after rook g7, now, and yeah, this is easy, for example. This is easy to understand this. Yes, I think this is easy to understand. So which is the plan? If you know the target, then you can realize how to win the position. Okay, this is it. So, okay. First of all, you must realize some things like this. For example, if you have the time to cut the king, it's okay, it's easy. So the major problem, how to realize this endgame, because I can never realize when to play king h5 or not. Doesn't matter if you realize when to play king h5 or like this. You just remember, put the rook and g3 or g5, and then look what will happen. With the rook on g5, we'll listen what is happening if white plays the rook on g5. Doesn't matter if it's the best move or not. So according to computer must give a check. King h6 and bishop c2. This is one of the positions you must know by heart, this position. You must know by heart how to win this position. To win this position, it's easy. If you go king h5, no, rook g7. Yes, rook g7 is the way. This is never a defense because you give a check and you go there, so only move is king f8. So only go rook g3. Know the technique, g5 and g3 squares. So now usually here they go king f7, and now what you must learn, king h5. If you know the move king h5 is enough. Why king h5 is enough? Listen to this. Two possibilities, king f6, let's see, rook g5. Bishop d1, what else there? King h6. If you can realize that this position is winning for white, then you can realize the endgame. Why this position is winning for white? This is the winning position. Why? Because you threat king g4 and king f4. He must give a check to stop it. You give here, and now with the king there, you always have this threat. So now there is no defense for him, because if he moves the king like king f7, you give intermediate check, which is not so difficult to find. If he goes king f8, you have king d6, adios amigos. And if he goes king f6, you simply go rook g1, and then you cut the king and you win. So, as a target in this endgame, if you just use the third and the fifth rank, yes, it's good, it's easy. If you just use on luck g3 and g5, and just to know the target, which is the target? The target is to reach this position. If you know this is the winning position, doesn't matter where is black bishop. Just to know this is the target, because you threat king c4. This is exactly what you must learn. This is exactly what you must learn. And after bishop here, you must simply know this. And over king f7, this. This is the winning technique. This is the technique to win this endgame. If you know this technique, from the beginning of the endgame, you will find the position to do it. Just remember, because many people made this mistake. Yes, Keropoulos didn't know this technique. This is the winning technique, guys. Know this position is winning. And if you know a winning position, which is this one, this is the winning position for white, then it's easy to find the way to win. So many mistakes have been made in the position. So listen how easy it was. For example, in the book, let's say like this of Yusupov. For example, as I know in the book, so sorry, bishop d3, let's see this. So here is the rook g3, bishop d3, okay, rook g3, doesn't matter if you go rook g3 or rook g5. I know also the other thing, which I know like this. I know, for example, in this kind of situation that you can go easily king g5. When the bishop on e4, he can never go the king on f8 because you always have king f4 check. Yes, and the other thing you must know in endgame in general, if you have problem of winning this endgame, let's suppose in this position, king f6. No, this is very easy to win. Sorry. Wait to see what is the problem. When I was junior, I always thought this was a difficult endgame to win. Now that I see it as a grandmaster, I cannot understand how to make it wrong. This is my problem. So wait. So let's go rook g3, for example. No, this is easy winning. So yes. Oh, sorry. Sorry. So because always there is a threat to move the king. There is only one defense for him, which I didn't show. So bishop c2, yes, king h5, this is the position. So what, he must go king f7. King f7. So for example, a defense for him here, which I didn't show, the second resource, because The move king f6, as I told you, rook g5, king f6 is completely winning. The second defense for black is to play bishop d1 check. What happened to the stockfish? Wait a moment. Where is the position? King e7. Suppose here it was black to move. Not h5, sorry. Suppose it was black to move. Suppose king f7. Rook g3. Okay, suppose here it was black to move. What I mean? For example. Okay, for example, see this. For example, just remember the move king h5. Why king h5 in general is winning? There is never the second defense. If you know the move king f6, rook g5, if you know this resource that is winning, this is the simplest winning position. So if you know this is enough. The second thing you must know in this endgame, that never the move bishop d1 is a defense. Why never bishop d1 is a defense? Because always you go king g5. We say that you threat king f4. So his only defense is king g7. And after the move rook c3, because you control his bishop, now his bishop is ultra bad. This is a very bad bishop. Now the position is easily winning. Because the bishop cannot go back to protect the h7 square. So now your pawn is so easy and it can be promoted queen. Doesn't matter what he will play. For example, bishop a4. And now it's time to push the pawn because the bishop cannot enter the diagonal. So h5. And now the position is supposed to be winning. Let's go bishop e8, for example. I just play the simple move. Now it doesn't matter what you play. Doesn't matter. Just push the pawn. King g8 and you go rook h7. Okay, let's go king h8, for example. Oh, king h8, no, I cannot go king g8. But also I have this, okay. But okay, let's go rook c7, for example. Easy winning position for me. Because I go h7 and king h6. So this is the things you must know in this endgame. I think it was okay.